Good morning, students. Yesterday, in previous class, we completed 23 problems about the topic tangent and normals. And remaining problems 24, 25, do homework, and 26 is a multiple choice question. That also, the slope of the normal to the curve y is equal to x cube plus 3 sin x at x is equal to 0. So just they asked slope. 26 and 27, the line y is equal to x plus 1 is the tangent to the curve at the point. Tangent means dy by dx of the curve y square is equal to, y is equal to 26th problem, y is equal to x plus 1 is the tangent to the curve y square is equal to 4x. So the slope of the tangent is 2y dy by dx is equal to 4x dy by dx is equal to 4x by 2y, that implies 2x by y. So this is at x is equal, there is no point given, a line given. What is the slope? The slope is equal to 1, y is equal to mx plus c. Equate these two, 2x by y is equal to 1, 2x by y is equal to 1. They ask the line at the point, so that implies x is equal to y by 2. Substitute in this one, x is equal to y by 2, you get answer x value. Of course, find y value, that also multiple choice question. So, do this multiple problems. So, we completed this tangent and normal concept. Let's start today new concept, approximations. Approximations. Using derivatives, new concept. Okay, first means rate of change of quantity, next increasing decreasing to find the interval where the function is increasing decreasing using derivatives, and next using derivatives to find the equation of tangent and normal, and next using the derivative to find the approximation values of the given function or given some value. So, okay, right. Approximation of some functions. Suppose you take like this. Okay, f maps d to r, these subset of real numbers. In that, take one function y is equal to f of x. Y is equal to f of x, a function. Let it be p point x comma y. P point x comma y. So this is q x plus delta x, y plus delta y. This is nothing but delta y, and this is dy. Here dx is equal to delta x. Let it be, this is r point, this is q point, and this is nothing but s point. S point x plus dx comma y plus dy. Okay, let it be, this is the s point, this is the q point. Correct. Okay, take a function, y is equal to f of x, a function, let p point x comma y, and dx is equal to, that is nothing but a delta x. Small increment, delta x is the small increment,
small increment in x, small increment in x, increment in y is corresponding increment in x, that is nothing but delta y. Increment in y is corresponding, depend on corresponding increment in x, that is denoted by delta y. So this also increment in increment in y. So from the point Q, what is x plus delta x? X plus delta x means that is x coordinate. Y plus delta y is nothing but y coordinate. So x plus delta f of, so this is belongs to the domain f of x plus delta x. That implies delta y is equal to, or suppose f of x plus delta x is equal to y plus delta y from that. Okay, so therefore delta y is equal to, this is f of x plus delta x, f of x plus delta x minus y. Minus y means f of x plus delta x minus, this is nothing but f of x. Delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x from that definition. Okay, suppose let it be dx is the differential of x, that is nothing but dx, which is denoted by dx is equal to delta x. Differential of x, dx is equal to delta x. Like that, differential of dy is denoted by dy is equal to f dash x into delta x. That implies f dash x into delta x, that is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx into delta x. Why means, why take this means, suppose limit a small increment, delta x is a small increment, that is nothing but delta x tends to 0. In previous session we had discussed about this one, delta y by delta x is nothing but dy by dx. Therefore, that implies dy by dx is nothing but f dash x. Okay, so dy is equal to f dash x into dx is equal to delta x, that is nothing but delta x. So therefore, dy, differential of y, dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x, dx is equal to delta x. Okay, right. In this, delta x is the small change, small increment compared with the x. What you observe from this, delta x is the small increment or small change in x. But dy is a good approximation of this changing y means delta y. So that's why not equal, dy is not equal to delta y, just approximately equal to. So therefore dy is approximately equal to delta y. Here dx is equal to delta x, which is small change. So small change in x compared with the x, but dy is the approximate change in delta y. So that's what you understand from this concept. Dependent variable, differentiable of dependent. What is dependent variable? Y is equal to f of x. Y is equal to f of x. This is the dependent variable, this is independent variable. Differential of dependent variable is not equal to change in, means that is nothing but increment in y, not equal to. But independent variable, differential of independent variable is equal to increment of that value. Okay, understand? This is the concept of approximations. Okay, these are the problems from point 4. Using differentials, find the approximate value of each of the following up to places of three places of decimal. So they asked three places of decimal. What they asked? Using differentials. Using differentials, find the approximate value of the following up to three places of decimal. Okay, after point decimal, three places. First question, root of 25.3. Root of 25.3. Find the approximate value. Approximate value is nothing but here dy. Dy. Find out that is nothing but dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Use that formula. Okay. Solution. Take y is equal to root x. Take y is equal to root x. Let the x is equal to, from this, x is equal to 25 and change in x, delta x. Delta x is equal to 0.3. 25 point, okay, tradition 25 point plus 0.3. This is delta x is equal to 25 and delta x is equal to 0.3. Oh, we know the formula. What is the formula? Delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x. F of x plus delta x minus f of x. So that is nothing but what is f of x? That is x plus delta x. Therefore, x plus delta x. F of x plus delta. What is f of x? Y. Y is f of x. F of x is root of. Root of. So delta x plus delta x minus. Oh, understand? So this is x plus delta x plus change in x. Change in x is 0.3, x is equal to 25. So total value 25 plus 0.3, that is nothing but 25.3 minus root x. Root x means f of x. So like this, from that you will understand what understand means. F of x plus delta x is equal to y plus delta y. This value. F of x is equal to 1. So we want delta y. Delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus y. How can you write y is equal to? Y can be written as f of x. So this is the operative formula. F of x plus delta x. F of x, nothing but y. So y is what? Take y is equal to root of x plus delta x minus f of x. F of x means y. Y is equal to root x. So use this one. Right. Delta y means what is this value? X plus delta x means 25 plus 0.3 minus what is this value? Root x. Root x means x plus 25. That is equal to, we want this value, approximate value of this one. That implies 25 plus 0.3 is equal to delta 1 plus root 25. This can be written as, that implies 25.3 is equal to delta 1 plus 5. What is delta 1? Delta y is nothing but dy, approximately changes. So, but dy is approximately equal to delta y. How can you write? Dy is approximately equal to delta y. Therefore, what is dy? Dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Right. What is dy? Dy is equal to dy by dx. What is y? Root x. So dy dx of dy dx of root x into delta x y. What is delta x y? 0.3. dy dx of root x, derivative of root x, 1 by 2 root x into 0.3. Okay, 1 by x value, 25 into 0.3, therefore 1 by 2 into 5 into 0.3. This value is equal to 0.03. Right, that one. Therefore, what is dy is equal to 0.3. Therefore, finally, substituting this one, therefore 25.3 root of approximately equal to delta y plus 10 dy. What is dy value? 0.03 plus 5. 0.03 plus 5. That is equal to 5.03. So therefore, this is the approximate value of, like this, 25.3. So using like this differentials to find the approximate value of the given any one, square root value or cube root values or fourth root values, like this one. Okay, so this is the first of all, once again, find the using differential, find the approximate value of the this one. Okay, let us take y is equal to root x. Let y is equal to root x. In this, let x is equal to 25.3 can be written as 25 plus 0.3. Let it be this x. A small increment of x is delta x, that is equal to 0.3. Okay, right. What is the power? Delta y is equal to root of x plus delta x minus root x. Remember, that is nothing but delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x. So f of x plus delta x means f of x is equal to here root x, that implies root of x plus delta x minus f of x. F of x means y. Y means what here? Root x. Right. X plus delta x. X is equal to 25. Small increment in x, that is given 0.3 minus x value root 25. So this is equal to delta y plus 1. But dy is approximately equal to the delta y. Approximately equal to delta y. Dy is approximately equal to delta y. That implies dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Find out dy value 0.03. Therefore, approximate value of 25.3 root is approximately equal to 5.03. Okay, students. Right. Next question. Root 49.5. Square root here also. Square root of 49.5. Solution. Take y is equal to root means cube root means take cube root. Only square root means take square root. Let this is 49 plus 0.5. 49.5 can be written as 49 plus 0.5. Right. Let x is equal to, this is 49, and increment in x, delta small increment delta x is equal to 0.5. Small increment delta x is equal to 0.5. We know the formula. What is delta y? Delta y is equal to root of x plus delta x minus root of x. Okay, open it. Delta y is equal to x means 49 plus 0.5 minus root of 49. Root of 49. Therefore, 49 plus 0.5 approximately equal to delta y plus root 49. What is 49 value? 7. Okay, but dy is the approximate value of delta y. That is, what is increment? What is dy? Dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. What is y value? Y value is root x. Root x into delta x value. 0.5. Dy is equal to 1 by 2 root x into 0.5. 1 by root 49 into 0.5. 1 by root 49 value, what is value? Root 49 value is 7 into 0.5. So 0.5 divided by 14. Okay. 5 by 140. How many times should we cancel? 5 ones and this one here. 5 twos 10, 5 eights, 1 by 28. So you can calculate 28, 0.0, 28 how many times? 28, 3 times only, 3 times 28 threes, 84, 84 means 6, here is 1, 1, 6. Okay, 0.03, what one more value? How many times? 28. Suppose we take 6, 8, okay, cross. So that is nothing but to take 0.35. So approximately 0.35. Round off with 0.04. That is equal to 0.04. Therefore, approximate value of 49.5 approximately equal to dy plus 7 approximately equal to, what is dy value? 0.04 plus 7 approximately equal to 7.04. 49.5 is equal to 7.04. So like this. Next problem. Third one. 0.6. How can write this one? 0.6. Let us take y is equal to root x. Y is equal to root x, and next let x is equal to, so 0.6 can written as, how can write in terms of x plus delta x, x plus delta x, not only plus, x value is a perfect square. How can you write in previous problems 25.3, x value can you write a perfect square. So take 25 is a perfect square. 49 point, what is the value? 49.5. 49.5 means you can write part, x value right to possible value. Square root possible exact value. Square root exact value is 7. This also 5. Like that you can take x value. How can you write? 0.6. Suppose that x, x is equal to 1. Okay. And delta x is equal to, delta x is equal to, what is it? 0.6 you want. What? 0.6. Suppose if you take minus 0.4, suppose 1.00 subtract 0.4, subtract 0.4. What is the value? Subtract. So now 10 minus 4, 6, 0.6. Like that only. Remaining process is same as it is. What is delta x is equal to 1, delta x is equal to minus 0.4, we know delta y is equal to under square root x plus delta x minus, this is root x, okay, delta y is equal to x plus delta x makes 1, minus 0.4, delta x value minus, 1 minus 0.4 minus root 1, therefore this is 0.6. Okay, is equal to, that implies is equal to delta y plus square root 1. Square root 1 value 1. 0.6 is equal to delta y plus 1. But dy is approximate value of delta y. Therefore, dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Okay, dy means square root of x, 1 by 2 root x, 1 by 2 root x into delta x value minus, minus 0.4, minus 0.4, that implies 1 by 2 root x, root of 1 into minus 0.4, therefore 1 by 2 into minus 0.4. Okay. Right, what is dy? Dy is equal to minus 0.2. 0.2 times cancel. So finally, 0.6 can be written as approximately delta y plus dy. Delta y is approximate value of dy is approximate value of delta y. Therefore, approximately dy minus 0.2 plus 1. Minus 0.2 plus 1, subtract 1, 0.2, subtract means 8, 0.8. Suppose, okay, under square root of, if you want to take this one, what is this value? 64, so therefore, after 2 decimals, 0.64. This is the approximate value. Okay, like this one. This problem, do like this one. Let's see next one. This can be written as
want under square root value like this also tick. Y is equal to root x. Y is equal to root x. This is 0.6. 0.64. Suppose, for example, got answer 0.8. 0.8 into 0.8 value 8 8s 64 and 0 0 6. So that implies 0 8 0 0 0 0 4 6 0 0.64 this value. Okay, right? Take like that one. Let it be x is equal to 0.64. Okay, but if you take this one, 0.64. What is remaining value? We want 0.6. Let us take like this one. Okay, we get 0.64. 0.64 delta x. What is delta x? 0.04. 0.04. 0.604. Right? 0.04. Okay. Better to take like this one. By the formula, delta y is equal to root of x plus delta x minus root x minus root x. That implies x plus delta x is equal to 0.64. This is minus of minus 0.04 minus 0.04. Okay, minus 0.04 under square root of x value. X value is equal to 0.64. Okay, therefore that implies 0.64 minus 0.04. This is equal to 0.6 minus under square root. This value is equal to like that one. 0.8 into 0.8, 0.64. Therefore, this value is equal to 0.8. Sorry, without square. 0.8. Now, 0.6 is equal to delta y plus 0.8. Delta y, take this side. Now, dy is the approximate value of delta y. But dy is the approximate value of delta y. Dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Okay. What is dy by dx? D by dx of root x into delta x minus of 0.04. Minus of 0.04 1 by 2 root x into minus 0.04. Okay, previous we did 1 or like take like this one. No need that one, that method. Dy is equal to 1 by 2 into x value 0.64 into minus 0.04. That is equal to 0.64 value 0.8. 2 into 0.8 minus 0.04. That implies minus 0.04. This is how many times? Minus 0.02 times. This is 0.8. Okay. This value can be written as again two times you know, divides minus 0.01 by 0.4. So to remove this decimal, multiple with 100 by 100. So that implies minus 1 by 40 minus 1 by 40. Okay, divides how many times? Here also 100. 40, 0.4, 2, 80, 20, 5, 200 above, okay? 200. 0 point, minus 0.25. Minus 0.25. Right. So finally, 0.6 under square root is approximately equal to dy. Delta y plus dy plus 0.8 approximately equal to what is this value? Minus 0.25 plus 0.8. Okay, subtract from this 0.80 minus 0.25. This is equal to 5, and here 7 minus 2, 5. Okay. This is equal to 0.55. Once check this one. From 10, some mistake. Under square root, okay, 2, 0.02 times, again 0.01, 0.4, and minus 1/40. 1/40 means, okay, minus 0.25. So that is equal to dy. 0.25 plus 0.82. So that implies 0.80, 0.25, 5. Here 7 minus 2. 5 more. Okay, approximate value. Did not get. Once you check. 42s, 80, 20, okay, 45s, 5 zeros, 5 fours, 200. So that is okay, clear. Alright, 0.025. Right. 0.025. So that implies 0.80. One more zero. 0.025. 0.025. Now 5. Now 5. Next term. 9 minus 2. 7. Here. 0.7, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7, 5, 0.0, 7, 7,
4, 5. 5, 12, 10. And this is 6, 7 plus 3, 10. And next 10, 6. Okay. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 6 decimals. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So, 0.60025. So that implies 0.6. So this is the approximate value. This is the approximate value. So finally, what is this approximate value is 0.6 is approximately equal to 0.775. Students. Next problem, 0.009, fourth one, 0.09 whole power 1 by 2, 0.009 whole power 1 by 2, right. This is cube root of, this is the previous three problems. Square root of 25.3, square root of 49.5 and square root of 0.6. Those are the square root. X value consider, what is the exact value, perfect square, what is the perfect square? That only take x value. Here also like that, cube root. Cube root means what is the perfect cube value. So first of all, let's take y is equal to cube root of x. Previous square root of x, here take cube root of x and let x is equal to 0.009. What is the perfect cube of 0.009? So this can be written as, let it be 0.008 and small increment delta x is equal to 0.001, small increment delta x is equal to 0.001. How can we check once this one? Cube root means, suppose, what is cube root? 0.2 whole cube means 0.2 into 0.2. What is the answer? 0.2 into 0.2. 0.224 to 0, 0, 0, 4, 0. So after 2 decimals. Again 0.2, 2 4 8, 0, 0. This is 0, 0, 0. So finally, 8, 0, 0, 0. So after 3 decimals. So 0.008. So this is the perfect. Right. So like that, plus 0.08 plus 0.001. So that is 0.009. Right. Delta y is equal to root of x plus delta x minus root x. Therefore, delta y is equal to x plus, x means this one, 0.08 plus 0.01 minus root x, 0.008. This is equal to, therefore, 0.009 square root is equal to delta y plus 0.008. Okay, so what is this value? Delta y plus 0.2, 0, sorry, cube root. This is the cube root. Cube root of 0.08. Okay, right, cube root of means this can be written as 0.2 whole cube 1 by 3. 3 cancel. Right. But dy is approximately equal to delta y. What is dy? Dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx into delta x. Okay. Right. Dy is equal to, what is dy by dx? Cube root of x. d by dx of x to the power of 1 by 3. Cube root can be written as x to the power of 1 by 3.
Right.
Cube root of x to the power 1 root. What is derivative? Into delta x. Into delta x. dy is equal to x to the power of n. N into x to the power of n minus 1. X to the power of n minus 1. Into delta x. Delta x is equal to 0.001. Therefore, x to the power of 1 by 3 minus 1. Minus 2 by 3. 1 by 3 x to the power of minus 2 by 3 into 0.01. Therefore, 1 by 3 into second numerator, denominator, x to the power of 2 by 3 into 0.001. Therefore, 1 by 3, x value. X value is 0.08. 0.08 whole power 2 by 3. This value is equal to 0.001. Therefore, 0.001 divided by 3 of 0.2 whole cube whole to the power of 2 by 3. If we cancel, that implies 0.001 divided by 3 into 0.2 whole square. 0.2 whole square. 0.001 divided by 3 of 0.04. So this is equal to 0.001 divided by 3 4 stop 0.12. Okay, what is that? Therefore, 0.09 value is equal to delta by place dy approximately equal to dy. Dy plus 0.2. Therefore, approximately equal to 0.01 divided by 0.12 into 0.2. So, to remove this decimal value, here how much? 1000 by 1000. That implies 1 divided by 120. 1 divided by 120. How many times it cancel? 120. Okay. 120. 900, not 9, 800, 820s. Okay. 8s. Here 0.0. Okay. 0.08. How many times? 960. So what is 960 means? This is 0, 10 minus 6, 40. So 400. Still how many times? Okay, you know, 0.008. How many times? 363. So approximately this is equal to 0.0083. plus 0.2. Approximately equal to, add these two, 0.2, 0.0083. That implies 3802. Therefore, 0.208. 3 decimals enough. 0.208. Okay. This. Okay, students, we will continue next remaining problems in next class.